It's the Golden Globe award-winning musical that claimed a record-breaking box office haul of nearly $500 million.
So different from this hell I'm living.
Now, to coincide with the DVD release of Les Miserables, one of the stars has revealed the film's secrets exclusively to 10 News. ...22-year-old Samantha Barks, who beat half of Hollywood to land the role of Eponine, teaming up with on-set pianist Jennifer White, showing us how earpiece technology was used for the very first time, allowing the cast to perform all 52 songs live rather than lip-sync to a pre-recorded track. 10 News also given a first look behind the scenes, touring the many British locations where the epic film was shot.
Well, it is a freezing afternoon here. That's the first sun we've seen all day. And in fact, the film was shot here this time last year, so we've been given a real first-hand taste of what it must have been like for the cast and crew. And we found out from some of the guys that were working here that it was so cold filming some of those scenes that Anne Hathaway kept warm with a hot water bottle. It mustn't have been much fun at all.
Before sitting down with the very talented and very friendly Samantha Barks.
Well, Sam, this has been a great day for me because I've heard you sing not once but at least half a dozen times.
Yes.
You must clearly love what you do.
I love what I do. I'm you must be sick of my voice by now. I've just been singing it all morning. I just love it. I absolutely do.
On my own, pretending he's beside me.
I did this song 8 shows a week for a year of my life, yet every time I sing it, I feel so, I have a buzz after singing it because it's so beautifully written that I feel very, very fortunate to get to sing it every time.
I feel his arms around me, and when I lose my way, I close my eyes.
Surely you must be a little bit sick of hearing it.
I'm not sick of hearing it. It never rests in my soul.
You did 15 takes of that iconic scene, but you're also quite lucky because you got to walk into a film where you were able to perform that song live each and every time. How good as an actor was that for you?
It's incredibly freeing having the process of singing live. It's, you know, you dream of having that situation where you can almost forget that you're singing. You do forget you're singing because you just feel like you're kind of saying these thoughts intimately and truthfully. If I was to have pre-recorded this a month before, I'd have been confined to whatever tempo I'd set for myself, whatever dynamic I'd set for myself. But with this, on the day, you could just all of a sudden get to a verse and go, I don't feel like this part is built enough to be that loud or, you know, to be that. You could kind of be as free as you want to make the choices in the present moment.
That doesn't mean it was easy, though, was it? Talk me through some of the challenges.
You couldn't actually hear me because of the volume of the rain, because we had a real rain machine. It was freezing cold. And so then next minute I turned around and the sound department had raced off and put mattresses on every surface that wasn't seen by the camera. We got to the end of the day and someone was like, what's that? We can hear like a chattering. They were like, oh, it's Sam's teeth, it's fine, action. I was like, it was so cold.
Yes, 24601.
My name is Jean Valjean.
Now, the film has been a huge success. We like to think as there's been a bit of an Australian influence. Hugh Jackman, Russell Crowe, you've worked with both of them. What were they like?
They are fantastic. They really were. The whole cast were just a dream to work with. But, you know, having Hugh and Russell as our leading men was so fantastic because they're both such different actors and suited those roles so perfectly.
And you've become friends. I mean, we've seen some photos of you and Russell. I think you went to the gym together in America sometime. You've kept in touch with them, obviously.
We've all kind of kept in contact. You become kind of a team, and I think that we all bonded through that.
We'll have to have you out to Australia. Have you been before?
I've never been, no.
If you do come, Russell will have to take you to the footy. He he looks after my team, the South Sydney Rabbitohs.
Really?
Did he tell you about them at all?
Actually, on set, as a gift, he handed out caps to the entire cast, so that was fantastic. Everyone's got a cap.
We can count you as a South Sydney fan then.
How can I ever face my fellow men? How can I ever face myself again?
Now, I know there's only room for two Australians in this film, but I was hoping you might be able to share some of your warm-up techniques.
It's just whatever helps you get to that vocal place. So for me, the kind of oddest one that is floating around, I go, meow, meow, meow. You can try that one.
Meow, 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 meow.
Let's do another one. You can go, lip trill.
Oh, the lip trill. Okay.
You could be in Les Miserables.
Well, you know, Hugh'd better watch his back. I'm coming up. I'm coming
I'll
up.
I'll tell him that.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by.
It must have been a lot of fun, but hard work. We've been out to some of the areas where the film was made. It's not as glamorous as people might think, this filmmaking business.
Nothing about Les Miserables was glamorous. I'd sit in the makeup chair and be sprayed down with mud. You know, my eyes would be made to look more tired, my hair to look, you know, and it was just like, it was a make down every morning. And it was just so funny seeing yourself. You know, you start in the morning and, you know, when you wake up in the morning, you always think, oh, I look a bit dodgy, I look a bit tired, I'm a bit, mm. And then you'd go into makeup and you just see yourself getting progressively worse. And it's kind of, it's really exciting. I don't know, something cool about being sprayed down with mud every day.
Sitting on the Isle of Man, did you ever think that one day you would be here in a film alongside Hugh Jackman, Anne Hathaway?
Not at all. And it's every day, I just... feel so lucky to be doing it. I think I grew up on the Isle of Man, it's 85,000 people. Didn't wake up when I was three going, I'm gonna be a singer, I wanna be a superstar. I didn't, I just did it every day because it put a smile on my face and I loved it. I was kind of driven by the passion. I never thought that a few years later I'd be meowing at you in this room, so.
You're very humble, but in honesty, it can't have been easy. London is a tough city. Everyone wants to be on stage, they wanna be on film, they wanna be successful. And there are so few places. What would you say to other young people who might be sitting on the Isle of Man or in Outback Australia or wherever they might be who has that dream? What would you say to them about going forward and achieving that?
Dream big, take chances, throw yourself in at the deep end. But that's not enough. You then have to, once you're in the deep end, swim and swim and swim till you get, you know, till you swim up. And never give up. Don't be kind of, I think, don't get carried away by praise and compliments. Don't sort of get wrapped up in that, but also don't dwell on failure or criticism. Pick yourself up and plow on again, throw yourself in again. You know, just take chances and work hard.
The show goes on.
Exactly, the show must go on.